Let's do a quick video talking about what you need to know as a data scientist, as a machine learning engineer, to make use of AWS. Now, I'm talking about just quick pop-up instances that you might run to train for 3 hours or so. I'm not talking about ML ops where you're going to maybe have a web server facing the public, backed by machine learning, lots of more security ramifications going on there. We're just going to talk about the bare minimum, get you going. Now, there's a lot of opinions on what you might want to use in AWS, so let me know in the comments what you think of this, if you have different ways that you go about this. I'm talking about the techniques that I use to get into these instances and gain access, not necessarily the best way, but they work for me. First thing we're going to deal with is IAM. This is the security in Amazon. It's set up really for Fortune 500 companies all the way down to just somebody like me logging in. So it's a bit cumbersome, I would tend to say. IAM is right here. If it's not showing up, just go to all services. And here you can see I have 9 users set up. There's user groups, there's roles. There's a lot to this, like I said. I'm gonna go to the users page. I'm blanking this out a bit because I don't necessarily want you to see all of the users that I have set up. Add user. Here I get to set the username. I'm just gonna call this test user. Now I tend to create multiple users for each of the major activities that I have going on with Amazon. That way, if one of these is exploited, they won't have access to everything. It's going to be for programmatic access only. That way they can't log into this console. You go to next and permissions. This is where it can get fairly complicated. And you can see I've got my groups blanked out here, but you could define groups if you're getting more advanced. I would suggest, if you're just getting started, attach security policies directly. And you can go through here and you can find policies that you want to put in directly from Amazon. And you can add as many of them as you want. This is one that I commonly use, Amazon EC2 Container Registry Full Access. So I'm going to give it access to that. That lets you pull things from the ECR, which is Amazon's container repository. You'll need that if you want to use NVIDIA NGC, which we'll be dealing with in the next video. Then you go to tags. I'm not going to tag anything. Review it, and you create the user. You can see basically that the user has been created. Now, this is very important. This access key and secret access key, we're going to download those. And you won't get that again. You're going to need to remember that. And you can reissue keys later on, and they recommend that you do. But the CSV file, we'll pop that open in a bit when we open up the EC2 instance. So that is how you create an IAM. Now let's launch an actual EC2 instance. And we'll launch it as a spot instance. So I'm clicking on EC2. You can see instances running is 0. And I have nothing running. There's some non-running instances, but we won't worry about those. I'm going to click on Launch Instances. Now, in a future video, I'm going to show you Boto 3, where you can do this all programmatically through Python, which is normally how I launch this kind of stuff. But this is how you do it, just starting out using the console for everything. We need to tell it the AMI, or the image. This is lower level even than Docker. We're going to run Docker on top of this. I'm going to go to the marketplace and I'm going to get an NVIDIA image. This is the same image that you use for NVIDIA NGC that we'll be using in the next video. But I like it because it's a very baseline Docker sort of launch pad. I'm just going to do NVIDIA. I want the NVIDIA Deep Learning AMI, so this one. So they're giving you some approximate pricing details. The ones that I particularly like are the P3.2 XLarge. That's just one V100 GPU. I get it working on this, and then I do these more expensive instances. We'll be using Spot, so we'll be paying about 1/3 of that. I'm going to click Continue, and we'll choose the instance type. NVIDIA recommends a P3.2 XLarge, and I agree with NVIDIA. And there it is. These are just additional GPUs and lots of CPUs, and then they also have the new A100s available as well. Gonna go next to configure instance details. This is a very important page. There is a lot going on here. We're going to switch it over to a spot instance. This will save us a lot of money. Normally, this instance is around $3, but this will get us for less than $1 an hour. Amazon can shut you off. You're buying excess compute resources. However, I found they rarely do. I have run these things for days and not gotten cut off. You generally do want to make your code so that it's saving to a location that if this does terminate, then you're not going to lose your work. So checkpoint. Notice it's not available in every availability zone, AZs as they're called. That's where you need to adjust this or you'll get an error. So you can see B is available, so we'll switch to that one. And that's really all that you need to do here. We're not doing anything fancier like multiple IP addresses. Next, we could add storage. Nothing particularly we want there. I usually don't add storage here because if I do have a lot of additional storage, it's going to be off in S3. However, just keeping things simple, if you want to run it all on this local instance, you can bump that up from 32 to something much larger. Don't need any tags. Security group is important. I like to run everything through SSH because this is not something that's being deployed out into production. This is a pop-up that I'm going to use for a couple of days or a couple of hours. So I will typically take these off. So this is my strong wall around my city. You've got to penetrate it through port 22. Everything is going to tunnel right through there. Now I'll go to review and launch. Not eligible for free is fine. And yeah, we could improve security, but we're not going to. That is not too bad of a situation. You could run the whole thing entirely inside of a VPC, but let's go ahead and launch it. This is very important. Your key pair. This is local to me, so I'm not telling you too much, letting you know that my key pair is named Jeff Heaton. But I'm going to create a new key pair just to keep it interesting. I will sometimes launch these without a key pair. Then literally there is no ingress into it. And I will sometimes launch it even without that tunneling port, because if it's going to run just as a dumb node and then send data off to S3 for me, I don't need any way to access it from the outside world. But I'm going to create a new key pair. I'm going to call this test, and you download your key pair now. And this is your private key. If you give that to somebody, they can log into this instance for you, which you don't want them to do. So let me go ahead and launch this instance. This takes a moment, and we'll see what to do with that file in a moment. There's two programs that you want to install, at a minimum Putty, and then probably WinSCP as well. You see links to them in the description section. I'm not going to go through how to install them. They're very easy to install. So now that that is going, let me go ahead and go back to the console. We'll go back to EC2. You'll notice that I now do have a running instance here. It has an instance ID and a public IP address. You want to know this public IP address. That's quite important. I'm just going to copy it. This is a little notebook that I'm keeping information in. And there it is. So now we've got a spot instance running. Now that we have this instance running, we need to get into it and we also need a tunnel to it. So what we're going to do here is start up Putty and we need that IP address. Now you can get a static IP address. You can purchase multiple IP addresses from Amazon. This page that I'm doing here in Putty, but I'm putting in my IP address that we're going to connect to over port 22. So everything is going over port 22 to this instance. I am going to call this AWS demo. And then you have to go to here, the SSH, and you go to auth, and then browse. And notice that file that I downloaded is not there. This is because you have to convert it. It wants a PPK, and you got a PEM. Very easy to make that conversion. You're going to want to run something called PuttyGen. Should have been installed when you installed Putty. We're going to load an existing private key, and this is the private key loaded. Notice, though, that I did have to change this to all files, otherwise you don't see it. And this is your private key. This is what you absolutely do not want to show anybody. I'm going to delete this, so don't get too excited about mining bitcoins on my account. And you click Save Private Key. Oh, always a good idea to put a passphrase on it. I'm just going to put test 123. So we save the private key. Now it's going to be a PPK file. I'm going to call it test PPK. I suggest keeping both of these files. Some software that you use will want the PM, some will want the PPK. Mainly Putty will want the PPK. So you've got that. So now we can go back to Putty, browse, and we can get the PPK. We're not quite done yet. We've got to do one more thing, is under SSH, we need to establish a tunnel. And what this tunnel is going to do is allow us to open web connections to there. So I'm going to add a forwarded port. It's going to be 8888 and localhost 8888. This is on the other side in Amazon. We're taking localhost, which is it, 4/8, and mapping it to my computer's 4/8. Those don't have to be the same, but for convenience, I'm doing that. That's pretty much everything. Oh, and one important step, I always mess this up. Make sure you click add here, back on that configuration page. Go back to session, and I am going to save this just so that I have it. You can see why that's convenient to do a static IP address, because this will change each time you shut down that instance and restart it. And I'm going to go ahead and open it. This always happens the first time, accept, and you're ready to log in. The username is Ubuntu. B-U-N-T-U. Sometimes it'll be EC2 user, but in this case, it is Ubuntu. This is where you put in that passkey, test 123, and we're here. The first thing you want to do is just make sure your GPU is recognized. Do nvidia-smi. I've never seen this not be recognized. So you can see you've got a Tesla V100. You will not typically see fan speed on a data center GPU like this. You'll also note that you have Docker. And that's it. That's all you really have. This is a minimal AMI, but it's a launching pad for things with Docker and primarily Docker. Docker does take a moment the first time you invoke it. I believe it's starting a daemon. And there we have it. You can also open up multiple terminal connections to this. You probably don't want to establish tunnels on all of them, though. Another handy command is top. That shows you how much of your CPU you're using, not GPU. Okay, now let's run an actual Docker image so that we can see how to basically get Jupyter through the cloud. There's a bunch of ways to do this. I like tunneling it, because unless you're building something that's going to sit here running unattended and you want to connect to it through a domain name, then you're going to need to have an HTTPS certificate. And heaven help you if you just open up port 80 on this and go unencrypted. This is everything through that tunnel that is fully encrypted. I don't need a HTTP certificate because that private key that I downloaded, that's accomplishing basically the same thing. I know that this is me and I trust that it is Amazon. So you don't have that same trusted certificate need that you have with HTTPS. So what I'm going to do now is run this. You can run any Docker that you want. I typically prefix it with this. Run Docker, that's going to give me an interactive terminal. That's what IT means. RM means it's going to remove the container after it's done. You might also want to map some volumes so that you can store stuff outside of this container and inside of your EC2 instance. When I get to the more advanced examples, we'll certainly do that. And then I would use WinSCP to go and download them. When I do this in much more complicated examples, I'm using Boto3 and sending it off to S3, actually. Do you want to see more complex examples, how I run this in jobs that I will kick off and run for a few days and even restart on spot instance interrupts? Let me know in the comments and give the video a like if this is helpful to you. That's how I know what to expand upon. So I'm going to paste it into here. And we're going to run this TensorFlow with Jupyter. Now, normally this takes forever, but we are running this on the Amazon backbone. So it just pulls these Docker images like a crazy download. This is also where machine learning and hardcore software engineers differ. these Docker images are gigantic, usually 4 or 5 gigabytes sometimes, which would make a Node.js software developer crazy. I mean, those guys get excited about Docker images less than 30 megabytes. Hey, but I ran a Commodore 64 in my childhood. That's gigantic. Okay, we are up and running. The security token is a level of defense just to make sure that somebody unexpected doesn't log in as you. It's not really necessary because this is all through a tunnel. Again, this is very much kind of M&M security, hard outer shell like the candy, soft chocolate on the inside. So I've got that copied to my clipboard, and I'm going to actually just paste it right into here. 127.0.0.1 is my own local computer, but I've got that port mapped, tunneled, and there we are. We are in that Docker image. It even has some nice tutorials into there. If you had mapped a volume from your local instance, and I do recommend doing that, you would see your files here as well. But remember, your files are going to the EC2 instance, then you need to use WinSCP or something. And WinSCP, I'm not going to take you through that. It's very similar to Putty. You use that same certificate to log in. Don't need to do any tunneling. And we can get right into a notebook, and we are good to go. Thank you for watching this video. Do you want to see more on AWS? Let me know with a like. That's how I track what you're interested in. I always look at those videos with the most likes and the most subscribers gained. Or do you want to see things on Google Cloud or Azure? Let me know in the comments. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.